Hey guys, welcome back to some more X4, my current favorite game of all time, along with Star Sector and a bunch of other games. I love games. Who doesn't? So last time we kind of checked in, we were building out our station in Grand Exchange. We had made a water refinery or ice refinery. I always forget what the, I think water refinery. And so that is up and running. The next part of our project is to make a meat plant. So, when you do the main quest, meat production facilities are one of the blueprints that you get by default. So, we'll go ahead and build that. We're starting to earn credits at a pretty good clip here. We got 2.7 million. So, and we got 185,000 due from trades by my NPCs. So we are making credits pretty well, but we gotta start investing that back into our infrastructure here. As you can see, we've got energy cells, we've got ice, we got that going into water. It's currently producing. We have water being built, water being created. So now let's go ahead and make a meat, some meat facility. So as we've done before, we're gonna go in here. We can look at our production modules, and we have meat. And let's see where. So meat likes to be put on top. So let's see. So we can kind of put it right here. Now, do we want to put, I'm trying to think, do we want to make it? We'll just put it there. Oops, did I lose it? Okay. So, it is, I need to, sometimes this happens where there's something in the way. So spatial organizing here does kind of matter. But we can go ahead and solve that with our kind of other modules. So we'll put one right there. And now we should be able to get our meat plant on top of here. Oops, too far. Got. Can't get the view right. Right, meat production. Come on, meat. Can we put it out here? Oh, there we go. So, yeah, something was in the way of it. We'll put it right here. So we're building a cross connection and the meat production. This will cost us 1 million credits based off of the need for meat production. So why produce meat? Meat is used to make food rations, which can be used for habitats. And habitats will be one of the next things that we build that will habitats affect the people on the station and how efficient it is. So, as always, we need to assign a builder. And we got one right here. Nice and close. So, right click, select. All right, we got to make sure to give enough money so it can get the job done. Confirmed. Confirmed. All right, and we will start our way there. Construction will have
Engage.
been started. So I'm going to edit real quick to where it's done. Back in a second. Okay, we're back. Construction has been completed. So you can see here's that connection piece that we built. And up here is the meat factory. Such a weird name. So let's go check that out. Little interesting graphic artifacts. I'm not sure why that is like that, but you can see miscellaneous traffic happening. This is all the new station that we built. It's very cool. There's not much to look at inside. I'm guessing it'd be cool if there was like cows or something roaming around in there. But otherwise, the station's pretty neat looking. See anything in these windows? Oh, wait, are those the cows? Let's get up close. Those could be it. Yes. Check out the cows. That's awesome. I love it. I love the little details like that. Okay, so our meat factory is open. Go over here. Oh, and there's one more thing I wanted to see down here. A little, I don't know if this is like an advertisement or what, but yeah, this kind of automatically got created. This holographic stuff, which is really neat. Very cool. Okay, now to some of the details here. If we go to logical overview, we now see here's our energy and ice. Energy and ice make water. The water and energy make meat, and we have meat here. So meat production has already started. It's going on right now. We have about 2 hours until resources are depleted. So one question comes up is, all right, so right now we're selling all this. So we will sell water to those who ask. We will sell ice as well and buy ice. So, I mean, we'll buy ice. We won't sell ice, but we'll buy ice. We will buy and sell energy credits. We also buy and sell water. There are two ways to stop us from doing this. So maybe you just want to keep all your water. You can restrict trade with other factions. This means you won't sell. You won't trade with other factions. Or you can set the price high enough that it won't make sense for traders to come. So let's see. We can do automatic pricing for selling, but let's say we just want to... we'll still sell water, but it's going to be expensive if they want to buy it. That works for me. We can do automatic buying as well, and that's based off of supply and demand. And with our meat, we will go ahead and sell that as needed. So as you get to more advanced products, so this is like ice to water to meat, things are just slower. So we'll produce, it takes like, I forget what it was. It was like 5 or 6 minutes for each production cycle, so it gets more complicated. If we add a food ration factory, which I think we might do next, then we'll get another slot, and those will take even longer. So we'll get a full production chain out of this. But we have our meat production going. I don't know how much demand there's going to be for meat. We'll have to see. And so the station's looking good. Production is going good. We've got 3.1 million credits to spend. So yeah, everything's going well. I am enjoying the station. So yeah, next time we're going to work on expanding the station. We're also going to start building our station in Aragon, which is going to be a military-focused station, which, you know, should be a lot of fun. Because I want to start getting into some conquest, and we're going to need some supplies to do that. So, catch you next time. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope it was helpful. Have a great day.